Hello, my name is Savannah Adams and I'm a graduate student here at NDSU. This is my second year conducting research both here at CREC as well as ATREC over in Hettinger. For my project, we have planted this pollinator planting right here, which is adjacent to our dry bean crops. Some of the goals of my project are to see which pollinators visit both the pollinator planting and the dry bean crops, and to see if those visitations to the dry bean crops help increase or improve yield in any way. Our pollinator planting here includes a diverse mix of 18 different forb species, which include both annual wildflowers and annual cover crop species. Some of the annual wildflowers we have included are Lacy Phacelia, Plains Coreopsis, and Indian Blanket. And some of the annual cover crop species we have included are buckwheat, flax, as well as some legumes, including some clovers and some brassica species as well. Over the 2 years of data collection, we have found that the bees have visited both the wildflowers and cover crops. Namely, we've found that Lacy Phacelia, which is a wildflower, is visited by all sorts of different species, and we have a variety of visitations on some cover crops like chickling vetch and crimson clover as well. The seed mixes can range in a variety of costs. It's important to provide non-crop floor resources for these pollinators so that they can be able to then provide those crucial pollination services to surrounding plants, including the crop species. For our crop, we've been using these Palomino pinto beans, which are classified as self-pollinating. Since they are self-pollinating, they are not managed with pollinators in mind. Despite that, however, we have found over our 2 years of data collection a wide variety of different insects visiting the bean crops themselves. Mostly we have found that bumblebee species like to visit the beans, but we have also seen a variety of honeybees, native bees, butterflies, and flies using the bean flowers themselves. These pictures that you're seeing are just a variety of the pollinators that we've seen both within the pollinator planting and the dry beans themselves to help show the diversity of the visitations in these areas and agroecosystems. And again, I would just like to stress the importance of providing non-crop floor resources to these pollinators in agroecosystems where maybe they may be more scarce and not as readily available to help support these pollinators so that they can then provide those pollination services back to these important crops.